duci.
He said, Dumitru, don't go.
Dumitru, se regreți.
Dumitru, you will regret it.
Tată, eu vreau să fac școala militară.
But dad, I want to go into the Navy.
Măi, dacă tu vrei, du-te, dar să-ți pară rău.
If you really want to, then go, but you'll be sorry.
Și m-am dus la școala militară de marină.
And so I went into Navy school.
Am făcut 4 ani jumate școala militară.
I stayed for 4.5 years.
Am ieșit ofițer de marină.
I became a naval officer.
Mi-au dat 80 de oameni în primire.
They gave me 80 new recruits.
M-au îmbăcat pe Marea Neagră.
They shipped me out on the Black Sea.
Mi-au dat ordin guvernul comunist.
And the communist government ordered me.
Să controlez vapoarele care vin din străinătate.
To check the ships that came in from foreign countries.
Răspuns Dumitri.
And he said, Dumitri,
dacă ai să găsești Biblie,
if you find Bibles,
să confiși Biblie, să arestiți pe misionari,
confiscate the Bibles and arrest the missionaries.
Repede să te ambasezi.
And then we will advance you quickly.
Când am auzit că Dumitru trebuie să ajungă în mare,
when I heard that Dumitru was able to advance,
m-am apucat să controlez puternic vapoarele.
I began to check the ships powerfully.
Și într-o dimineață a venit un vas din Olanda.
One morning a ship from Holland came in.
Și am intrat cu 8 oameni în control.
And I went in with 8 of my men.
Și sub niște lăzi de biscuiți.
Under some crates of cookies.
Am găsit o cantitate mare de Biblie.
I found very many Bibles.
Am chemat pe șeful vasului.
I called the captain of the ship.
Scatalis Bibliile.
Are these your Bibles, sir?
Zice, no.
He said no.
Zic, nu știi.
I said, do you know whose they are?
Lasă-i să știi tu.
He said, we'll find out together.
Dar într-o parte era un bărbat.
When I looked to one side, there was a man.
Plângea și se ruga lui Dumnezeu.
He was crying.
Văzut că el se roagă.
When I saw that he was praying.
Zic, al lui trebuie să fie Bibliile.
I thought the Bibles are his for sure.
Mă duc la el, dă-mi pașaportul.
I went to him and I asked, give me your passport, please.
Scoate pașaportul din buzunar.
He took his passport out of his pocket.
Era un misionar din Olanda.
He was a missionary from Holland. His name was Brother
Dick.
He worked with Open Doors Mission. I asked him, are these your Bibles, sir? He said, no. Whose are they then? They are your brothers and your sisters, he said. When he said this, I felt as though a knife went through my heart. But this was not enough. I began to hear a voice in my ear. What are you doing, Dimitri? Don't you know that I brought you here? You know your dad's a pastor. All your brothers are Christians. Don't do anything to this man. Tell some soldiers to protect him from the police. Give him his passport back. If you won't do this, I will punish you harshly. When he said he'd punish me, I turned to see who was speaking to me. But there was no one there. When I saw there was no one there, I began to shake. And who's speaking to me? But the voice kept speaking in my ear. Give him his passport or I'll punish you. I was embarrassed. I shook before the missionary. So I went into another compartment. And I stuck my fingers in my ears not to hear the voice anymore. But it got louder. Go, if you won't, I will punish you now. Give me his passport. Tell some men to protect him from the police. I went shaking before the missionary. I said, Mr.
Digg,
your God has answered your prayers. He sent his angel and he spoke into my ear. I will do nothing to you. I'll even tell some men to protect you from the police. Brothers, as I gave him the passport, the voice stopped. And I began to feel a new peace in my heart. I knew it was the voice of the angel of God. But don't you ever hear God's voice? When sin stands before you, when you see you're doing something you're not supposed to, doesn't something inside of you say it's not good, don't do it? Doesn't it?
You know,
this is the voice of the angel of God. He tells you not to do evil. But see, then the devil comes. Hey, look, you can sin. David sinned. He was still king. God forgave him. Brothers, let's not deceive ourselves. David was a king. He was under the law. And in the old days, you could sacrifice animals for your sins. But for our sins, there was Christ who died. And through his wounds we're healed. And through his blood we're cleansed of all sin.
Amen.
We had a meeting with the Mormons
in Utah.
In Utah.
Vreau să vă spun ca să nu vă las nespus.
I'd like to tell you a bit about it so that you know you won't be.
Știți cum sunt mormonii.
But you know how Mormons are.
Au fost atâta popor că nu pot să numer.
There were so many people in there.
Și când am început să le spun.
And I began to speak to them.
Voi credeți în cartea lui Mormon?
You guys believe in the Book of Mormon?
Voi credeți în cartea lui Joseph Smith?
And in the Book of Joseph Smith?
Dar în cartea aceasta voi nu credeți.
But you're deceived. You should believe in this book.
Adevărata carte.
The only true book.
Care ne poate duce în fericire. Nu-i cartea lui Mormon.
You know, it's not the Book of Mormon.
Nu-i cartea lui Joseph Smith.
And it's not the Book of Joseph Smith.
Nu-i cartea lui Duduman.
It's not the Book of Duduman.
Adevărata carte e Biblia.
The only true book is the Bible. All the Mormons stood up. And they began to yell hallelujah.
Dar eu n-am știut ce s-a întâmplat.
I had no idea what was happening.
Dar s-a coborât un înger al Domnului.
At the end I found out.
Ca să-i încredințeze pe ei că ce vorbim noi.
All of them saw an angel of the Lord coming down.
Este de la Duhul lui Dumnezeu.
So that they understand what we say is from the Spirit of God.
Dumnezeu și-a făcut mari lucrări între ei.
And God brought out many people from among them.
Aș dori să lucreze și în mijlocul vostru.
I pray God work among your hearts too.
Așa m-au primit mormonii de bine.
You know, the Mormons accepted us very well.
Am fost primit la pentecostalți în alte biserici.
But then they began to hate us because so many people were excommunicated.
Puterea lui Dumnezeu.
Still they saw the power of God.
Aș vrea să simțiți voi puterea, nu să o vedeți.
You know, I pray that you feel the power of God, not see it.
Amen. Hallelujah. Am stat, fraților, 2 ani jumate pe Marea Neagră.
Brothers, I was on the Black Sea for 2.5 years.
Erau foarte mulți misionari.
Very many missionaries came through.
Ei se spuneau unul la altul.
You know, they would tell one another.
Și eu îi ajutam pe toți.
And so I would help them all.
Eram plin de bucurie.
I was full of joy now.
Că făceam și eu ceva pentru Dumnezeu.
I knew that I was doing something for God.
Simțeam o bucurie în inima mea.
I felt this joy in my heart.
Eu ajut să care Biblia.
I knew I was helping someone take in the Word of God.
După 2 ani jumate au început prigoana creștinilor.
But after 2.5 years, they began to persecute the Christians.
Odată ori din guvernul comunist.
The communist government ordered
toți copiii, indiferent de funcții, să plece acasă.
All Christian children, no matter what rank, to go home.
O trebuie să plec acasă.
I had to go home also.
M-am dus foarte supărat.
But I was very sad.
M-am dus cu gândul să mă răzbun pe părinți.
I went with the thought of taking revenge on my parents.
Din cauza pocăințelor am pierdut serviciul.
Because they were Christians, I lost my job.
Și m-a văzut mama supărat.
My mother saw that I was sad.
Mă întreabă, ce-i cu tine, mai băiate?
So she said, what's wrong with you, son?
Ce ești așa de supărat?
Why are you so sad?
Din cauza pocăinței voastre m-au dat afară din armată.
I said, well, because you're Christians, they kicked me out of the army.
Unde-i tata?
Where's dad at?
La adunare.
He's in church.
O să mă duc să-l fac de râs.
Well, then I'll go embarrass him there, I said.
Nu te duce mai, stai că vine acasă.
She said, wait, don't go, he'll be home soon.
Nu mă duc acolo.
But I said, no, I'm going there.
Când am ajuns la ușă.
When I got to the door of the church.
Cântau o cântare așa frumoasă.
They were singing such a beautiful song.
Cum ați cântat și voi azi.
Like you guys sang this morning.
Nu pot uita niciodată.
But I'll never forget this
vreau
one song.
Vreau să vă spun un verset.
I'll tell you a verse of it.
A venit de mult de sus.
Long ago he came from above.
Păstorul cel bun Iisus.
The good shepherd Jesus Christ.
Și prin lumea umblat.
And he traveled throughout the world.
Oi pierdute a căutat.
Looking for lost sheep.
Eu eram oaia pierdută.
I thought, I'm the lost sheep.
Eu am fugit de acasă.
I ran away from home.
Și Hristos m-a găsit pe Marea Neagră.
And Christ found me on the Black Sea.
Am început să plâng, fraților.
I began to cry, brothers.
Am început să plâng. Simțeam că bate ceva la inima mea.
I felt something knocking at my heart.
Aș vrea să simți și tu.
I would like you to feel the same.
Era ciocanul Duhului Sfânt.
The hammer of the Holy Spirit.
Plângeam, nu mă puteam opri.
You know, I was crying and I couldn't
am
stop.
Am dat 3 batiste.
I wet 3 handkerchiefs.
Mi-era rușine că plâng.
I was embarrassed how I was crying.
De ce plâng eu?
I'm a man.
M-am uitat rata în adunare să văd dacă mai plânge cineva.
I looked in the church to see who else was crying.
Plângea tata de bucurie că m-a văzut la adunare.
Only my dad was, because he was happy he saw me in church.
Apropii de tata, ajung tata, dar eu de ce plâng?
So I go to him and I said, Dad, why am I crying? He said, I'll tell you at the end of the service. At the end he asked me to stand. And he said, Dumitru, are you really sorry they kicked you out? I said, yes I am, Dad. Then he said, look brothers, the answer to our prayers. We have been praying for 2 years that he be kicked out. Then he said, God needs officers in his army also. Now you must come to God, son.
Da, tata, da, lasă-mă să
I said, I will, Dad, but let me get married first.
Păi eu, fată, din adunare,
he said, good, marry a girl from our church.
Zic, n-am ce-s eu de la tine, că tăt-i săraci.
I said, can't from here, they're all poor.